let us see nature of energy. You can hear energy as sound. Also, you can see energy as light and you can feel it as wind. So, energy is all around you. You use energy when you hit a football, lift your book bag, compress a spring. Living organisms need energy for growth and movement. Energy is involved when a bird flies, a bomb explodes, rain falls from the sky, and electricity flows in a wire. What is energy? That it can be involved in so many different activities. Energy can be defined as the ability to do work. If an object or organism does work, the object or organism uses energy. Because of the direct connection between energy and work, energy is measured in the same unit as work, that is joule. In addition to using energy to do work, objects gain energy because work is being done on them. Now, here there are five forms of energy. The five main forms of energy are heat, chemical, electromagnetic, nuclear, and mechanical. Then what is heat energy? The internal motion of the atoms is called heat energy because moving particles produce heat. Then heat energy can be produced by friction. Heat energy causes changes in temperature and phase of any form of matter. Then what is chemical energy? Here, chemical energy is required to bond atoms together. And when bonds are broken, energy is released. Here, fuel and food are forms of stored chemical energy. Then what is electromagnetic energy? Power lines carry electromagnetic energy into your home in the form of electricity. Light is a form of electromagnetic energy. Each color of light represents a different amount of electromagnetic energy. Electromagnetic energy is also carried by X-rays, radio waves. Then what is nuclear energy? The nucleus of an atom is the source of nuclear energy. When the nucleus splits, nuclear energy is released in the form of heat energy and light energy. Nuclear energy is also released when nuclei collide at high speeds and join. The sun's energy is produced from a nuclear fusion reaction in which hydrogen nuclei fuse to form helium nuclei. Nuclear energy is the most concentrated form of energy. When work is done to an object, it acquires energy. The energy it acquires is known as mechanical energy. When you kick a football, you give mechanical energy to the football to make it move. When you throw a bowling ball, you give it energy. When that bowling ball hits the pins, some of the energy is transferred to the pins. Then, what is energy conversion? Energy can be changed from one form to another. Changes in the form of energy are called energy conversions. All forms of energy can be converted into other forms. The sun's energy through solar cells can be converted directly into electricity. Green plants convert sun's energy into starches and sugars. That is, here electromagnetic energy is converted into chemical energy. Now let us see some other energy conversions. In an electric motor, electromagnetic energy is converted to mechanical energy. In a battery, chemical energy is converted into electromagnetic energy. The mechanical energy of a waterfall is converted to electrical energy in a generator. Now, let us see some energy conversions. In an automobile engine, fuel is burned to convert chemical energy into heat energy. The heat energy is then changed into mechanical energy. Now let us see what are the states of energy. The most common energy conversion is the conversion between potential and kinetic energy. All forms of energy can be in either of two states, that is potential and kinetic. Potential energy and kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is the energy of motion, and potential energy is a stored energy. The energy of motion is called kinetic energy. The faster an object moves, the more kinetic energy it has. The greater the mass of a moving object, the more kinetic energy it has. And kinetic energy depends on both mass and velocity. Here, kinetic energy is equal to mass into velocity upon 2. What is the greater effect of kinetic energy, mass or velocity, and why? Then, potential energy is a stored energy. Stored chemically in fuel, the nucleus of atom, and in foods are stored because of the work done on it. That is, stretching a rubber band, winding a watch, pulling back on a bow's arrow, lifting a brick high in the air. These are the examples of potential energy. Then, let us see gravitational potential energy. Potential energy that is dependent on height is called as gravitational potential energy. Energy that is stored due to being stretched or compressed is called elastic potential energy. A waterfall, a suspension bridge, and a falling snowflake all have gravitational potential energy. If you stand on a 3-meter diving board, you have 3 times the GPE that you had on a 1-meter diving board. Here GPE means gravitational potential energy. The bigger they are, the harder they fall is not just a saying, it's true. Objects with more mass have greater gravitational potential energy. The formula to find gravitational potential energy is gravitational potential energy is equal to weight into height. So, kinetic potential energy conversion. Roller coaster work because of the energy that is built into the system. Initially, the cars are pulled mechanically up to the tallest hill, giving them a great deal of potential energy. From that point, the conversion between potential and kinetic energy powers the cars throughout the entire ride. at the point of maximum potential energy, the car has minimum kinetic energy. Let us see once again. At the point of maximum potential energy, the car has minimum kinetic energy. Here you can see. Then, what is kinetic potential energy convergence? As a basketball player throws the ball into the air, various energy conversion take place. Here you can see, when ball is going up, it is slowing down. Then, at the topmost level, maximum potential energy is there. Then, when the ball is coming downwards, the ball speeds up. And at the last stage, maximum kinetic energy is there. At the last stage, maximum kinetic energy is there. Then let us see the law of conversion of energy. Energy can be neither created nor destroyed by ordinary means. It can only be converted from one form to another. If energy seems to disappear, then scientists look for it, leading to many important discoveries. Now, what is law of conversion of energy? In 1905, Albert Einstein said that mass and energy can be converted into each other. He showed that if matter is destroyed, energy is created, and if energy is destroyed, mass is created. Hence, E is equal to mc square.